Hey, welcome back. Well, I'm on a little getaway vacation, and I brought my radio with me. I thought this would be a perfect opportunity to go over this portable setup. This antenna you've seen before, this is a Diamond X30A dual band antenna for 2 meter and 70 centimeter. It's really meant to be a base station antenna, but I've modified it for portable use. Now on the end, you can see that I put a black nylon cord with a small loop. This loop allows me to hang the tip of the antenna from a hook, which I use at home. And where I live, you're not allowed to have any ham radio antennas, so I'm always in the portable mode, if you will, and I'll set this up when I want to get on the air and take it down when I'm done. Now, I've also modified the base of this antenna, and I've shown this in a prior video. This is a series of PVC fittings that I've fit together to accommodate the base of the antenna. Now, I've made it so it can mount on a painter's pole mast and elevate this antenna up to 12 to 16 feet. I've also modified this with a screw-in adapter that allows me to mount this on a camera tripod, another great option for setting up a portable antenna. Now, I always have the cable wound up at the base of the antenna, and it's held on with a couple of bongo ties on the stainless steel loops that I use for guy wires when I have it mounted on a painter's pole mast. Okay, let's start with the battery. This is a 12-volt, 7-amp-hour sealed lead-acid battery. I picked it up very inexpensively for $8 at a swap meet. Now, the only thing I've done to it is modify it to hook up to my radio. First thing I did was add two of these adhesive cable ties to the very top part of the battery and then lock down the connector. And this is basically a pigtail that has an Anderson Powerole Connector at the end. We'll go over that in a future video. And then two F-style battery connectors. I basically locked it down on top of the battery, and I take a little piece of Velcro, which makes this more compact for storage, and just secure that tie so it's out of the way. When I'm ready to hook it up to my radio, I have another power pole on the end of my power supply cord to the radio. It has dual fuses, and basically you just connect these two together. Now that's the beauty of the Anderson power poles. On this connector, I have it semi-permanently locked together with a Anderson power pole lock. Again, we'll look at that in a future video. Now, this Anderson power pole connector can be secured temporarily with just a set of 4-inch zip ties. And basically, all you do is run one zip tie through one end and one through the other end, and then lock them together. This will give you a nice connection. And when you're ready to break it apart, it comes apart very easily by just snipping the zip ties. These Anderson power poles have become the standard for connection. So we have the lead-acid battery connected to the Yaesu. Let's get the antenna set up and get this rig on the air. Now, these are the ground plane radials for this antenna, and I basically have modified them two ways. I put a small vinyl cap on the end just for safety, and I removed the nut that was on the end of this radial and replaced it with a wing nut that's put on backwards, and that allows me to thread this radial into the antenna mast and then use the wing nut to secure it in place. Very easy to do in a portable setting, and it breaks down really quick. Okay, there we have the antenna with the radials, and it's ready to go. We can undo the bongo ties and extend the cable and plug it into the back of the radio. The last thing to get ready is the camera mount. Now, this is a PVC adapter that I made. It's basically a half-inch male iron pipe thread with a cap, and it's held together with a small section of half-inch pipe. In the center is a nut that is locked in place with epoxy, and that basically threads on the end of my camera mount secure it down tight, thread that in the base of the antenna mount, and that shows the flexibility of this particular adaption. You can mount this on a painter's pole, a camera tripod, or hang it from a hook up in the air, and this antenna is ready to go. So I'm going to turn the camera around, we'll aim it out front the window, and I'm going to put this on the camera tripod, extend this cable, and we'll get the FT-857 up on the air. Okay, this is a standard camera tripod, and again, we have the tripod mount all ready to go. You just clip it in place. And that gives a nice sturdy mount for this antenna. I'm going to detach the bongo ties. And I just leave them on the antenna so I can coil this coax back up when I'm done. So let's bring this in the house and get that radio on the air. Okay, we got the antenna hooked up out back, and this is the coax. This part is called a PL259. That's the name of this particular connector. That's pretty standard. And that goes in the back of the radio. And back here is for HF, and then this is for VHF, UHF. And that's where we plug this 2-meter antenna in. And that connector right there is an SO239, and that accepts the PL259. So you just plug that in and then screw down the connecting collar, and we are good to go. Now you might remember this frequency, 145.800, which is the downlink for the International Space Station. It's on split mode, and the transmit is 144.900. So first thing we want to do is go to the menu bar and turn split off. Now we're going to change this to the local repeater in Sisters, Oregon, which is W7DUX on 146.900. So if we push in the adjustment knob, we can go to 146 very quickly. And then for those of you with a Yaesu 857, you'll know if you briefly push the power button, you'll get a little running man icon here, and that'll allow me to go up to 900 really quick. Now we need to set this up for the repeater. So 146.900 is the repeater. We have a negative repeater shift. If you needed to change that, you just push the menu bar and go to menu D and press repeater. There's a positive no shift for simplex and a negative shift, which is what we want. Then we're going to go to menu E and turn the tone on to tone squelch. And the last thing we want to do, since we're running on a battery, is reduce the power output. So we're going to go to menu number 75 RF power, and it's set at 5. Previously, it was up at 50, and since we're using battery power, let's see if we can get out on 5 watts. Okay, we should be good to go here. All right, 146.900, the local repeater in Sisters, Oregon, W7DUX. Let's see if we can get a radio check. KF7ETX, radio check on battery power, please. Not sure if it's me or you, but I'm getting only partial bits of your transmission. Again, KF7ETX, I got KD7 out at Crooked River Ranch.
KD7RTE Mobile, do you copy me now? Over.
Got you loud and clear now. Thank you very much. I'm testing out my Yaesu 857 with a little 12-volt battery and a portable antenna in the backyard. Well, I got you loud and clear, and it sounds like we're both operating on low power here, so it sounds really good. I appreciate the radio check, and I'll wish you 73s. I'm a new ham. I have a technician's license. I'm studying for my general, and I love the 857, great radio, and a lot of little bells and whistles that I'm slowly exploring. Over. All right, guys, well, there you have it. We just did a radio check with this 857D powered by a 12-volt, 7-amp-hour sealed lead-acid battery. Worked great, and we got a good QSO with a local ham. How lucky is he to win one of these at a local ham fest? So that's something to keep in mind. Great way to meet fellow hams, socialize, and you never know, you might win something. Well, I'm pretty pleased with this setup. The next step is to get this packaged up so I can mount it in a backpack and take it out. I'm looking forward to doing some SOTA activations or summits on the air. And there's some local peaks around here, so that'll be fun. Now, the Anderson power poles are great. I can disconnect this 12-volt battery from the radio. And I've got a battery charger over here, and it has a Anderson power pole on the charging end. And I just plug that into this battery, turn the charger on, and we're ready to go. Now, I want to close this video with a shout out to a fellow YouTuber and amateur radio operator who comes to us from the other side of the pond in the United Kingdom. And I'll put a link down below so you can check out his channel, but trust me, you won't regret it. He's a real fun guy. His name is Mark, and his YouTube channel is Mark Beer Monster. Now, I can only imagine with that YouTube name that he probably enjoys a good brew every once in a while in the United Kingdom. And someday, I think it would be fun to shake his hand, share a draft, and talk about radios and other things. So anyway, Mark, I'm looking forward to that, my friend. So he sent me a package, and I'm actually holding off on this. I got this a couple of weeks ago. I'm going to tie this package, because I know what's in here, into this current set of videos that I'm working on. But he sent me some antenna wire, very special antenna wire that I was admiring, and I'm going to be looking at developing a dipole antenna with this wire, and hopefully that'll be when I get on the air with HF. But I will be opening this in the next day or so and posting a video so you guys can see that. I went to my local HRO or ham radio outlet and picked up the center feed for making a dipole, and I'm looking forward to getting this antenna wire hooked up to this and at least start listening on the HF bands. So, Mark, thanks very much. And I'll talk more about this antenna wire. It's kind of special wire, and I'm really excited about it. So, guys, thanks for stopping by, and I'll wish you all 73. And to all of you guys that are getting your license and have been sending me PMs, congratulations. I'm really excited for you guys, and hopefully I'll meet you on the air sometime. So, this is USNERDOC. Out.